isn't that same passage? He tells us that Jesus Christ did not come to condemn the world, but that through the world, through him the world might be saved. He says that those who are condemned already because they have not believed on the name of the only begotten Son of God. He says if you believe, you are not condemned because you have believed. The Bible teaches very plainly that all of us are sinners by nature, that every one of us have done wrong. Jesus himself defines it so plainly that he says if you have so much as had hatred in your heart for someone else, you are as guilty as having committed murder. He says if you lusted in your mind after a woman, you're as guilty as having committed adultery. All of these sins proceed forth from the heart. The Pharisees questioned Jesus, saying that it is what a man eats that will make him a sinner. But Jesus said, it's not what you eat that makes you a sinner. It is what comes forth from you, because that proceeds from the heart. You understand that all of us are sinners by nature. The Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. There is none righteous, no, not one. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. That's why the Bible tells us in this passage that we must realize that we are sinners. But I want you to understand today that according to the Word of God, the sin that is sending each person to hell is not because they're a murderer or something else. It is because of unbelief. It is because they have not received Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as Savior. You understand that, yes, while all of those things make us sinners, God says we are condemned because we have not believed on the name of the only begotten Son of God. The reason for that is because the wages or what we deserve for our sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You see, salvation is free. It is a gift available to you and I, to all who will come and believe on Jesus Christ. He has made salvation a free gift available to you. You just have to come and receive it by believing on the Lord Jesus Christ and Him alone. You understand the reason why unbelief is the sin that sends someone to hell is because it is only by belief that we can be saved. It is not by being a good person. It's not by doing good works. The Bible is so clear about this that it says that you're saved by grace through faith. It is the gift of God, not of works of righteousness, lest any man should boast. You and I cannot earn a place in heaven. We cannot be good enough to be righteous with God. Our righteousness is only when we are covered in the righteousness of Jesus Christ, when we are washed in the blood of Jesus Christ, trusting in the blood that He shed for us on His cross. You see, the reason why Jesus Christ died for us is to pay for all of those sins that make us sinners. He died there so that you and I could be forgiven, to pay that debt for us, so that God could have mercy on sinful mankind. And so salvation has been made available to all of us, so that God says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You understand today that all you must do is realize that you are a sinner. You must see the need for that Savior, to realize that being a good person will never be enough to get you to heaven. That way, with your heart, you can truly believe on Jesus Christ. For you see, if you're still trusting in good works, if you're still refusing to see that we are all sinners, the Bible is so clear. You're not looking to Jesus Christ. You're looking to yourself to get your redemption. But God says that it is only by Jesus Christ and His blood that was shed for us. It's only by His sacrifice on the cross. I am telling you today that if we'll realize we are sinners, God says that if we'll believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall be saved. Each one of us simply must come believing on Him. The Bible tells us in Romans 10 that if we believe with our heart, confess with our mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and that God has raised Him from the dead, if we'll accept what He done for us on the cross, believing that, He says with our heart, man believeth unto salvation. mercy was willing to go to the cross in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ, God in human flesh. He was willing to go and suffer and bleed and die for us as no man ever could, as no one else ever has. That's why God tells us, no greater love hath any man than this, that he that would lay down his life for the life of his friends. There is no greater love in all the universe than that of Jesus Christ, than that of God himself, being willing to pay all the cost of our sin, being willing to go to the cross to die for us. God loved you so much that he died for your sins and for my sins, that we could come and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, that we could come and trust in him, that legally speaking, we could be made right with God. You see, he satisfied whatever debts we may have. He paid the cost for you and I, that we could come and have eternal life that's already been paid for through Jesus Christ and his shed blood. All you must do today is realize that salvation is in him and him alone. There is no other name given among men whereby you must be saved. And come, believing on him and what he has done for you, that he might have give you that gift of eternal life that he says is full and free and readily available to all those who will come and believe on him.